Hello everyone, welcome to the computer class of class 5. We are going to be going back to our previous version of classes with a little bit of addition and subtraction. What is going to happen was, as we were doing in the midterm, we are going to be having a class video where I'm going to be discussing with you the chapter and the portion of the chapter, following which the video will be posted actually in the class GCR. You're going to watch the video, if possible with a headphone, best possible idea. Watch the video, follow it up with what is in there in your book. Take notes of whatever you do not understand, underline in your book. At the end of the video, you have two options. Option number one, we are going to be having an interactive class, that is going to be a Zoom class, which I think is more convenient for me. And I'm going to be having a Zoom class where you can ask me anything that you do not understand about the particular class that we took. And we can have a little bit of question answer sessions ourselves. Or what you can do is, if you happen to miss, you can just type in your queries or questions that you have about the computer class. So let us not discuss too much about other things. Let us begin with the class. Following the class, I'm going to be putting new things into your book. Very simple. Let's get back. Let's start with the computer class and open up your books on chapter number 4. Okay everyone, let's begin with chapter number 4 of your computer book. I hope you people are all ready. If you are not, you may pause this video. In fact, anytime you are in the video, if you think that there is something that you did not understand, you may pause the video, go back and re-listen to what I have just said. That's the best part about a pre-recorded class. If you are already on chapter number 4, page number 32, that is there on your screen. Let us begin with our chapter. Today we are going to be talking about managing files and folders and how Windows operating system manages files and folders. Now, what are files and folders? Let us begin with a small explanation. Yes. So what are files and folders? Every single information on a computer is in the form of a file. Every file is basically a bunch of computer data in bits, bytes, kilobytes, megabytes, gigabytes, depending upon what is the size of the file, right? So all information on computer are in the forms of files, and a folder is something in which you keep many files altogether. Alright? Now we will understand this as and when we go through the chapter. Now let us begin with our chapter right now. Windows 7 and its desktop. Today we're going to be talking about desktop. Okay, desktop is basically the first screen that comes on your computer or even your mobile phone. Fine, the desktop is the place where the actual work takes place. Just like your study table, which has got different drawers in which you keep different books, exercise books, stationery and other things. But in order to study, you need to take out those books and exercise books, keep them on the table and then study. That is the place where it is called desktop. Similarly, on the computer, the place where all the work takes place is known as desktop. Now, the desktop in a computer is designed in such a way that you can easily talk to the computer. Why? Because a computer generally understands only machine language, 0 and 1. Correct? Now, if you have to tell a computer something, you cannot be remembering all the codes of 0 and 1. Okay, it's very difficult, very boring, very not attractive. Okay, so to make your work interesting, the computer companies or software companies have made something called a desktop or an operating system. An operating system is basically like the owner of a shop. Okay, When you need something from a particular shop, you go to the shopkeeper and you tell him or her, what do you need? The shopkeeper goes into the shop, knows where is what. He or she takes things out and comes and gives it to you on the countertop. That's how a shopkeeper or shop works. Similarly, an operating system is basically a manner in which you communicate with the computer. You give a command in the operating system. The operating system converts it and gives it down to the computer and vice versa. So let us start reading. We are right now on the first line of the chapter. Just give me a moment. I'm going to be changing the cursor. Okay. So we are here. If you can see, my cursor has become very big. The Windows 7 and its desktop. Let us go through the chapter. Windows 7 uses a lot of pictures to help us work on computers easily. So it is also known as a user-friendly operating system. Windows is a user-friendly, something that is very easy for a person to use. Okay, that is why it is known as a user-friendly operating system. As soon as you switch on your PC, Windows desktop appears on the computer's monitor. The desktop serves as a surface for your work, like the top of your actual desk. Okay, just what I explained to you. There are several icons on the screen and taskbar at the bottom with the start button. The objects visible on the desktop provide several quick ways to use Windows and to start application. Now, the image that is given in your book is very much crystal clear. How does a desktop appear? Okay, you do not need a computer. It is very, very simple. It's very, very clearly given what is there on your screen. So if you just look at figure number 4.1, if you pay attention, this right at the bottom, there is a number given. Okay, while I'm teaching, I'm going to be referring to figure numbers. Okay, so please be very, very careful and follow. All image have got a figure number. So when I'm talking about a particular figure number, you should be able to identify which image that I'm talking about. Okay, like right now I'm talking about figure number 4.1. Okay, this is the Windows 7 desktop. Now if you look at the figure or the image, you see it is clearly given what is a taskbar, what is a wallpaper, and what is an icon. Okay, these are the three separate sections that are given. All right, now if I come to my desktop on my screen, if you pay attention, okay, this is my desktop. I'm very unfortunately, this is my personal picture. It's with my family. And if you just give me a moment, I'll just replace this picture so that you guys are not distracted. Personalize. Okay, let me continue with my family picture only. No issues. So this, as you can see, this photograph is my wallpaper. Right on the left hand side are my icons. On the left hand side, if you see very, very clearly, I'll put them as a large icons. You see, these are the large icons that I have. And if I'm taking some of them, control panel is here, recycle bin is here. This is not required right now. Yeah, so these are the various icons that are there on my computer. Yeah, I think I will keep OBS somewhere here. Yeah, so these are all icons. The image that you see is the wallpaper, and the right at the bottom is your desk, is your taskbar. Taskbar is a place where all the files that are being used right now are kept. Now if you see right at the bottom, I've got lots of taskbar icons. This is basically of settings. I'll just close this just now. This is my Google Chrome. This is OBS. OBS is this particular software. Okay, this I use to record my screen. Okay, so I'm using OBS right now. This is Droid camera. Droid camera is a particular software with which what I can do is what happens is I can convert my phone into a webcam. All right, because my phone's camera is always better. So I'm using my phone's camera as a webcam. All right, now right at the bottom, you see this is a snipping tool, and there are lots of other icons. You can keep any icon, any software that you use very regularly. These are the software that I use regularly. That is why I kept them. If you use something very, very regularly, you can keep them on taskbar so that it is very easy to launch them. All right, now let us come back to our chapter and let us carry on reading. Yes, so after the small quick tour of my desktop, let us start with this part. The desktop has various parts, some of which have been discussed in the previous class. Here we will discuss some icons. Now we have already discussed in the previous classes. We will have more discussions as and when we go ahead. So, but right now we are going to be talking about icons. Okay, and in the previous class I had given you some activities to perform. I give you some questions, and to my big surprise, most people have not done it, and I am not very happy about it. Let me be very, very clear. All work that you do from now on is going to be graded. You will get marks for everything you do in the class. That means if you don't do something, you will get a zero. Your term 2, that is the final exam, will be a combination of whatever you have done in the class along with the test. So if you give only the test and you don't do anything in the class, you will only get 50%. The remaining 50% you will not get. So please go and complete everything that is there in the GCR. Okay? Now, one of the questions that I had shared last week was, what is an icon? Okay, and I had told you, please read the chapter and answer from there. Unfortunately, most of you have not given the answer. Those who have given the answer have not given the right answer. Now, let us read the portion. An icon, icons are known as images on console. Okay, remember the word icon is not an abbreviation, it is an acronym. Now, what is the difference between abbreviation and acronym? Please go and ask your English teacher. That is your assignment. Okay, I'll be asking in the next class. What is the difference between an acronym and an abbreviation? So, icon stands for images on the console. They are pictorial representations of an object or applications on desktop. Double clicking on an icon opens it. Some common icons on desktop are explained in the next page. Okay, we'll start with icons, but before I carry on, just let me show you what the icons are all about. I don't like this Windows 10. Now you see these are different icons. On my left hand side also you see there are icons, and on my right hand side also you see there are icons, and these icons are basically pictorial references. Let me just remove this wallpaper of mine. I don't like it while I'm teaching the class. So background, sorry, color. Yeah, let me just keep it black. So there you see, this is an icon. You see right in the middle is the icon of my PC. It is a small pictorial representation of a computer. So this shows that this is a computer. Now this, if I show you, this is another icon that is there. This is an icon of network. You see there is a computer behind that, there is a globe. Why? Because a network refers to everything that is around the world. Alright? So these are called small pictorial references of what the software is actually all about. Now, right now you see these are like this. If I want, I can change the name. Like this PC, I can rename it to Alok PC. I can name it basically anything I want, alright? So, that is the idea. Just give me a moment. So, that is the idea with icons, and that is what icons are all about. Let us go back to our chapter once again and let us hurry up. Yes, come to page number 33, computer. The first icon that we are going to be talking about is a computer. Now, the image 4.2, all the icons are given. Remember, your book is talking with reference of Windows 7. I am using Windows 10. Most of you will come across Windows 7 only. But there is not too much of a difference. Zyada difference nahi hai, beshi difference nahi. Thik ache? It is as simple as that. If you just employ your brain and try to relate, it looks like this. Alright? It's just a little stylish, nothing else. So, what is a computer? This icon shows the devices that are inside the computer. Permanent memory devices such as hard drive, CD drive, removable memory devices such as flash drive, digital camera. Everything that is connected to your computer is shown inside the My Computer icon. Alright, everything that is connected, whether it is the hard drive that is inside, whether you connect a pen drive, you insert a CD, you connect a camera, everything that you connect to the computer is shown inside the My Computer. Now I'll just show you how what My Computer looks like to me. Sorry. And now this is my PC, and if I double click it, it will open, and you see right now it is showing you these are the various folders that are there. Also, these are three drives, right? I have only two drives on my machine, two parts of my hard drive, C drive and E drive. Okay, I only have C drive and E drive inside my hard drive. Basically, what I've done is my hard drive, I made it into two parts. Okay, two parts. My hard drive has got two different rooms. All right, one room is called the C drive, where I have all the Windows files. Okay, all the Windows softwares, everything is there. My personal files are inside the E drive. Okay, I do it this way. Others can do it differently. People can keep everything in C drive. You can also have only one drive. You can have more than two drives. You can have as many number of drives that you want. But currently, right now on my computer, there are two drives, and then there is the CD drive, which is empty. Right now my CD drive is empty. If I try to open it, see what does it say? It says insert disk. Okay, so that is what it is all about. My CD drive has got nothing inside it, and these are the, when you open Microsoft, when you open my computer, you get to see this. All right, whatever is inside. Now if you have to go to a particular file, you can open the particular drive, and you see these are the various folders that I have. All right, now let us come back to the chapter. So that is what a computer does. Let's start with the recycle bin. Recycle bin is basically your dustbin of the computer. What does a dustbin do? All things that you don't need, you keep it in the dustbin. Similarly, every file that you delete goes to the recycle bin. All right, they are there in the recycle bin. Remember, just like you keep things in the dustbin, one day what will happen, dustbin start filling up. So you have to empty the dustbin. So even in computer, you have to empty the recycle bin. Why do we not delete it ek bar mein? We don't do that because just in case we have deleted something by mistake. So it lies in the recycle bin, which we can go into the recycle bin and take it out. Very simply, very easily. Okay, that is the idea with the recycle bin. Fine. So if I just take you to my recycle bin here, I'll just take my PC back here, and I'll take my network back here. This is OBS. This is my recycle bin, right in the center of my screen. You see, this is a recycle bin. Okay, and if you see, this bin is full. If I open it, my computer is a little slow. Purane zamane ka machine hai, budhapa aa gaya hai isko. You see, these are the lots of files that are deleted at various times in life. Okay, now if there is a particular file that I have sent here by mistake, so I can take it back. And if all the files here are not required, I'll just have a look at them, all of them. Lagbena. Sorry for that. Okay, so if I want, all I need to do is, you see on top there is this bar which says empty recycle bin on the top left corner of my screen. You see, it says empty recycle bin. All I need to do is click there and all my files will go away. But that is one shot. Okay, if I just do this, see, it will ask you, are you sure you want to permanently delete these 85 items? I have got 85 files in my recycle bin. So if I just click yes, and there you see the process, it is deleting them one by one. 48, 49, 70, 72, and ta-da! My recycle bin is empty. Now if you just see, go back to the icon of recycle bin, you see right now the bin is khali. Pehle it was filled up because it has 85 items. Even if you send one item there, it will start filling up. Now I'll just show you. If I take this let's say I'll just take this. Inside this, you can click a mouse and drag it into the recycle bin and leave it. The moment you leave it, you see this file has gone from here to there. And now see my drive has become full again. Okay, if I just open it. Now suppose you have sent a file here by mistake. You want to take it back. Very simply, all you need to do is just click this file and do right click. When you do right click, there will be three options opening. One is restore, the other one is cut, and the third one is delete. Okay? If you restore, it will go back to where it came from. If you do cut, you can take it to another place. You can just cut it from here and paste it, just like simple cut and paste. Alright? And delete, of course, it will get permanently deleted. So the choice is yours. I don't need these files, so I'll just show you how to restore it. I'll just do right click here and restore, and see, the file has come back on my screen, on the left hand side of my screen. So that is my restore. Okay, just a second. Yes, so that is restore for you, and that is recycle bin for you. Let us continue to the next one. Shortcut icons. Now shortcut icons is another question that I've given you, and I told you read the chapter. You people did not read the chapter. Let us go through the shortcut paragraph and then we will talk about it. What is a shortcut? These are icons with small arrows in the left corner. They are used to quickly open a file or a program. For example, if you double click the Internet Explorer icon on the Internet Explorer window, appears. Now what is a shortcut icon? A shortcut icon, I'll show you what is a shortcut icon. Now you see this is a shortcut icon. Why is this a shortcut icon? This is also a shortcut icon. This is also a shortcut icon. Why is this a shortcut icon? If you pay attention, there is a small arrow here in the corner. Okay, those people who cannot see it on your mobile phone, just go keep take it closer to you. There's a small arrow in the left hand side corner. This arrow shows that this is not an original file. It is a shortcut. What is a shortcut? Sometimes when you install something or you keep a file, it is in some corner of your computer. Now every time you have to open that file, what you need to do is you need to open one section, then go to the next section, then go to the third section, then fourth section, to make to make matters simple for you. The computer gives you an option of what is known as a shortcut. Now I'll just show you how does the shortcut work. This is of course a software. Give me a moment, just adjust these things. So yes, I'll just open up this particular file, computers. My computer. I will go to my class, computers. This is a folder for class 5. Okay. Now see what I had to do. I had to take 3 steps. First open this, then open this, then go to school, then go to computers, and then I have come to class 5. Alright? So instead of this long process, what I can do is very very simply, I'll go to the folder for which I want a shortcut. I'll do right click. This long option will appear. Here you will find an option called send to. I want to send it to the desktop, and if I come to the desktop, it says create shortcut. I do create shortcut. Now you see there is another folder of 5. It says 5 shortcut here. All I need to do is just double click, and straight away my folder will open wherever it is. So this is what a shortcut does. It takes you straight to where you need to go to. Alright, now sorry for that, I need to empty my recycle bin. So that is what a shortcut. So the difference between a shortcut file and an original file, you see this is the folder and this is the file. This is an original file. There is no arrow here, but while this one is a shortcut because there is an arrow here. If you delete an original file, the original file, the main file, will go to the dust, go to the recycle bin. But if you delete a shortcut, only the shortcut will go to the recycle bin. The main file will remain where it is. Alright? So you can delete a shortcut very easily, but do know, before you delete a main file, be careful. So next time you're deleting, you have to be careful. Is it a shortcut or is it the original file? Okay? Now, continuing with our class, the last thing on the two things that we are going to be talking about, files and folders. Files are sections of computer's memory, which I've already talked about. We'll go very, very fast. Folders used to store them. Now, let me show you what is the difference between a file and a folder. Now see, this is a folder. The yellow color thing is a folder. This folder contains lots of files like this. You see this red color PDF? This is a particular file. I can keep files inside a folder. I can keep a folder inside a folder. Okay? But a folder is no file in totality. Okay? Folder only collects things. Okay? If you see very carefully on my screen, lights are on. If you see very carefully on my screen, the folder contains small red things which are known as files. If I just open this folder, and you see this folder has got lots of other files. You see the ones on top, I just maximize it for you to see. You see, yes, inside this folder, I have got 1, 2, 3, 4 more folders, and then these are files. Basically, a folder is yellow in color, covering the files. Alright? So, a folder is one, I had already told you at the beginning of the class, is one in which you keep many files. We will discuss this more in the next classes. I will not go any further because this class is becoming too long. If you have not understood anything, please re-watch the video, note down your questions. I'll be joining you in an interactive class after this. So kindly go back to your GCR and wait for my next post. Okay? That will be all for today's class. With this is Alok sir saying bye-bye.
That's all, folks.